show that combines hip-hop, kung fu, and video games.
Show that has everything you care about?
This is The Forefront. So, today's Tuesday, and we just had a lot of people stop by. I think it was like Mark Wahlberg, a bunch, whoever else likes football. We had foosball here Sunday, Patriots versus Atlanta Falcons. Were you going for a side? Do you care?
No. I stay out of picking sides. It leads to disappointment.
Yeah. Especially when after 20 years, parents get divorced, and you don't, I love you, mom, I love you, dad. Oh, no, I shouldn't bring that in. that got awkward. So, last time you were here, Rachel, was your first time hearing about tricking.
Yeah, it was.
From the name, what were you expecting? And
oh, gosh, now that I already know what it is, when prostitutes work, it's called turning a trick. I didn't expect that it would be that, but then you made a joke about porn.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. Actually, 99% of the people that I say tricking, they instantly think dirty. And I love dark humor, but the one time.
It's real clean.
Yeah. When you saw it, what were you thinking? Like, you saw the flips, you're like, oh, that's...
It was impressive. If I could do that with my body, God, all the energy. I'd love to have that much energy.
I see you as one of the types that does have that.
You know what? I also recently was told I'm a high energy person.
Yes. Yes.
But I've just had such exhaustion on me. I mean, maybe it's just yelling at kids all day. It'll do it.
She has a lot of foster kids. She's like Angela.
That is not true.
Brad Pitt. She has she's adopted 7 black kids.
When I was in 7th grade, I did volunteer at a foster home. And it was a very interesting experience. I felt really out of place. And I felt bad that I had what I had and that they didn't. But no, I'm not yelling at kids of my own. And I'm not yelling at children.
I mean, because she adopted them from Ethiopia.
She didn't adopt them. They go to school. They're very wealthy children. They are fine.
She's married.
They all have nannies. I'm unmarried. Although, a child did ask me today why I wasn't married. I wanted to ask her why she wasn't married, but I know why she's not married. She's 4. I don't have such a good excuse age-wise.
Tricking music videos.
I'm Here.
So, what other movies have you seen recently?
I saw Passengers, and I enjoyed it, although I didn't think I would. And I guess not an issue, but like there were three people in that movie, maybe four, and I just thought, like, man, they do not need people anymore. Like, what am I gonna do? I mean, I'm not a person. Those, like, Jennifer Lawrence, like, they are people. So, it was a little disappointing. Just, like, disheartening for me. But the movie was good. I like the storyline-ish. You know that so Jennifer Lawrence gets woken up by Chris Pratt.
I remember.
Chris Pratt does it without permission, obviously. You know that they're gonna figure it out and it's gonna go bad and then are they gonna get back together in the end. But it didn't bother me that I knew how it was gonna go.
It was predictable, but...
but satisfying, just because they were, I don't know, they're pretty people.
Yeah, who wouldn't want to be woken up by Chris Pratt? I saw La La Land. I loved it.
Really?
There's
what did you like about it?
The continual shots.
The cinematography?
Yeah. There's this one person who's in the French Foreign Press. Those are people that vote for the Academy Awards. And he gave a harsh review of it and just made me laugh out loud. He said, I don't see why this film got more Oscar nominations than The Godfather. It's about, word for word, he goes, it's about L.A. I guess there's just a lot of narcissists out there. It's overrated, and it somehow also got more nominations than Singing in the Rain. I hope people understand the problem with this later. I laughed my ass off reading that. Like, I liked the movie, but
I think people appreciated that it was like a throwback to old Hollywood style, but they didn't cast actors that could sing. They didn't cast actors that could dance. They had a whole tap break that was the most basic tap that there is. I mean, if you're going to stop and do a tap break on that hill, like, make it interesting.
Ryan learned the piano just for that movie.
And that was the saving grace of the movie.
I'm not...
but Emma didn't learn to sing.
Yeah, I felt that. They said they wanted it a little more authentic, and that's why, but...
authenticity? I can authentically sing.
Yeah. She can.
And it's, like, not bad. I mean, the authenticity argument doesn't make any sense to me, because authentically there are many people in the world that can sing well. So it wouldn't be... it took me out of the story that they couldn't sing, rather than helping the story along that they would be able to... it was definitely just a star-driven vehicle of, like, let's get all the awards and money, and, well, it clearly worked. They knew what they were doing.
I also saw this movie the other day, Turbo Kid. You've got to check it out.
I pulled it up on Netflix. I read the description. I thought, I bet I'd be interested in that. And then I fell asleep.
Right. As I would expect somebody with narcolepsy, she randomly does fall asleep. Like... what's the show on HBO? Westworld.
Which I also haven't seen. I have HBO. How do you watch HBO shows?
There's a stand-up comic from the Secret Group. You know them?
Yes.
He posted... HBO hired him for something. I don't know what they hired him for. But he was like, all right, so they hire me, but fuck them, man. Here's a free HBO login.
Oh, what?
Yeah, I screenshotted it. I was like... is this really going to work? It did. I'm still using it. He also posts his ex-girlfriend phone number on Facebook a lot in a hilarious post.
A phone number for who?
His ex-girlfriend.
Do you call her?
I was thinking about it today.
To say what?
Hold on. So the joke that he normally does is, you won't believe who Trump picked for his new cabinet. It's this person's name. Give them a call. It's not actually this senator, it's just my whore of an ex-girlfriend. Call her. It gets you every time because you don't see it coming. But yeah, so off of that note, what's next?
Oh, rapid refresh.
Welcome back. I am here with the next big horror movie director, the queen of Scream herself, Jocelyn Redarte. All right, right now it's time for a little rapid refresh. We got about 15 good horror movies, or some good, some not so good, selected just for you, our faithful viewers. All right, let's get 50 seconds on the clock. All right, ready, and start.
Cabin Fever, Eli Roth. How can you go wrong with Eli Roth?
Say no more.
Burial Grounds. This was actually really good. Had boob ripping coming off. I mean, zombies. It was good.
40 seconds. You had me up boob ripping off.
House of a Thousand Corpses. Rob Zombie. You Rob can't Zombie. Say nothing more? Flesh Eaters. Guy from Night of the Living Dead. It was okay.
30 seconds.
Last House on the Left. Wes Craven. Rape. What?
What? Shop and take my money.
Macarba. By Bar. It was okay. It was not.
Nah. 20 seconds.
Let's
20
see.
Seconds.
The New York Ripper. That was okay.
Yeah.
The Beyond, and that wasn't even, Day of the Dead, George A. Romero, zombies.
10 seconds, shop and take my money.
Exactly. High Tension, it was interesting, it was a French film.
Time.
Oh, darn.
Frozen, comedy?
What? No, ski lift.
Did you want to talk about it?
Yeah, sure.
We'll do it next
time.
All right, and that was Rapid Refresh. Thank you for stopping by, Jocelyn. She's going to have some good horror movies come out for you soon in theaters. Going to be worth checking out. All right, back to you.
Welcome back!
Oh, you went and got those Hot Pockets. Don't burn your tongue. They're still hot. Give them a second to cool down. Up next, what do we have?
Oh, up next, we have... Up next is...
No, you're...
Rachel! Tricky music videos!
Our executive producer, Will Sanders, everybody. Up next is tricky music videos.
Apparently.
One of these days the sky's gonna break and everything will escape, and I know it's you and I were made for this. I was made to taste your kiss. We were made to never fall away. Never fall away. Even though you left me here,
Welcome back! All right, we're about to play a new game called True Confessions or True Confessions. And we need a third player for this. So to get this party started, you know her from Rec Room in my so-called Mondays.
And also the owner of Natasha Navon Photography, best place in town to get your headshots.
Please welcome Natasha Navon!
Thank you.
So humble. Thank you. Now, in these envelopes, we have one truth and one lie. It is the other two players' time to guess which one is true and which one is the lie within 60 seconds. Since these two lovelies have not played this game before, I will let you interrogate me. Pick card number one or two.
One.
Great.
One. I once worked as a bouncer at nightclubs when I was in high school.
Where did you live?
North side of Houston, Greens Point area.
What was the nightclub?
They were illegal. I would guess they were illegal nightclubs. They're super shady.
You would guess?
There are some illegal nightclubs. Very shady, but I was like...
Called what?
I don't remember. They're all Spanish names. They're literally all Spanish names.
What was the clientele?
No offense. I think most of them were like illegal.
Did you ever bounce any of them?
Oh, yeah.
How can you be a bouncer when you're not even 18?
Because they're all paid under the table and most of the stuff going
on. How did you get the job?
I forgot. Let's start the time. Let's say we're...
I've already been timing. You have 20 seconds left. How'd you get the job?
A friend was already working there. He was in high school.
What was your friend's name?
Chris.
And why did your parents let you work at night so late?
Because my mom had no idea.
How much money did you make?
I think after 2 weeks I was getting like $80.
Time.
A week.
That is false.
I think it's true.
I think it's false.
I think it's true.
I think it's false.
Okay.
It's true.
What? That's ridiculous. Your parents were not paying attention to you. That is a lesson.
You know what was a clear sign?
What?
I asked you what your friend's name, you didn't even miss a beat, and you said Chris.
Mm-hmm. But that was the only question he had an actual answer for.
My turn.
Cool.
Yes. All okay, right. Mine going together. So I am going to read both of them, and you have 60 seconds to ask me questions to figure out which one's true and which one's false.
All right.
I began heavily drinking my freshman year at UT Austin. I began heavily doing drugs my freshman year at UT Austin.
Ooh.
Start the clock.
What was your favorite drink?
Gin and tonic.
When did you start doing St. Arnold's?
I still don't do St. Arnold's.
Oh my gosh. You know what I meant.
No, I don't.
That was a trick question. Well, we sell St. Arnold's at the bar I work at, Rec Room Houston, but I don't really drink it that much.
Okay.
Which friends hung out with you while you smoked?
All of my stoner friends that lived with me at Dobie.
Do you still talk to them?
No.
Okay. Who bought the drinks and who bought the drugs?
The drugs my roommates bought, and the drinks my senior and junior friends in the theater department bought.
Do you talk to any of the people in the theater department?
Some. When I go to Chicago, I think about talking to them.
How often did you call your mother?
Like 25 times a day. How often do I call my mother? Like 25 times a day. Hey, Mom.
How did that change from high school?
Well, I lived with her.
Time.
Exactly. I think it was the drinking that's a lie.
I think I'm going to go with her because... No, wait. I think I'm going to go with the smoking. That's the lie.
What does the winner get?
You get more fed, pizza. Woman.
I did not drink until I was 21 years old.
Ba-bow!
Okay. Rachel?
All right.
You pick a card for her.
One or two?
Two.
All right.
Two.
True or false? When in college in Nebraska, I ate corn at least once a week.
Start. What kind of corn?
On the cob.
What'd you put on it?
Butter.
Did you eat it because you live in Nebraska or because you like it?
Because it was easily accessible.
Were you broke at the time?
Yes, I was in college.
Do you still eat corn?
No. Not very often.
What color is corn?
Yellow, but there's white in it.
Do you like corn?
I did at the time. I did a lot of like frying it up.
What would you fry it in?
Oil.
Could you still fry it today if you wanted?
Yeah, I like to put it in eggs.
Who did you eat corn with?
My friend Jesse, my friend Kelsey, Tennille really liked it.
Did you buy canned corn?
No, there was no point. We were in, it was like fresh country.
I say it's true.
Yeah, I say it's true also.
Yes.
It's false, I never ate corn.
Oh my gosh.
I didn't even know they sold corn on the common.
Damn you, Ruben.
She was so good.
Damn you, Ruben.
She started like 3 months ago.
She was so good with that.
You know, I should have guessed because when I put corn in our eggs, you're like, I've never done this before. Corn!
I know, interesting. Yeah, it was really good. I like it.
Corn's delicious.
Yeah.
I never heard.
And tea. Most of the time.
She's really good. I have to be careful around her.
Yeah. I'm an actress. That was not the most interesting of my cards.
Let's just hear what your other one is.
The other one was that I once won a dance-off in the street on Halloween against two men considerably less drunk than I.
Well, I knew that was true.
I did tell that story because it's a good story.
My other card was I worked at two different Victoria's Secret stores when I was 19.
Obviously fake.
You sure?
Well, the other one was the truth.
Yeah, I messed up. I accidentally put two truths.
What?
That's actually true. I did. I'll give my story and you give yours. I jokingly applied at Victoria's Secret as a joke, and they called me back. I was like, let's see how far this goes.
How was the money?
It was good because I originally applied at like Best Buy, didn't get hired. And when they called me, I was like, well, I'm not seeing any. One, so I didn't have. I didn't have
you
to
didn't buy anything.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So,
Whereas Best can, Buy.
Yeah.
You'd buy lots of stuff.
Yeah.
That's a really good first job, though, Best Buy. I don't know about Victoria's Secret.
Actually, I think two of my boyfriends, their first job has been at Best Buy.
Yeah, a lot of people start at Best Buy.
I don't know why that happens.
My brother tried to get a job at Best Buy, but he didn't. He went to Target.
And did he get a job there?
Yeah, and now he works for Microsoft.
Has nothing to do with Target.
Just saying.
You want to know what the secret is about Victoria? She is a bitch to work for.
Corporate America. Hashtag get out. Hashtag Trump's president. Hashtag fuck it.
Well, I think that concludes the show. Thank you to Rachel and Tasha for stopping by. This has been the one show that combines hip-hop, kung fu, and video games.
The one show that has everything you care about.
I'm Tasha Gorel, signing off for Cory Lawrence and Rachel Rubin.
Saying, we hope to see you next time, right here on The Forefront. Kisses, hugs, and belly rubs. I'm going to have to edit this part out. Looking at her, I want to say Tasha, but you're Rachel. No, she's Tasha.
No.
It's okay.
That was good, man. That was hilarious. That was really good.